What's up, y'all? It's me, your boy, Ultimate Vitality here again with another stream, another discussion stream. The dogs are fighting. That's what they do. Also, Prophet, thank you for the follow, bro. You are now a vital follower. And what's going on, Kaitreya? Welcome to the Vital Essence, everyone. Hope you all are having a good day. I'm kind of having a good day. Big chilling. Here to have a nice little discussion. Tristan, what? Mm-hmm. Quit. If you would stop running, she wouldn't chase you. If you would be sitting down, she wouldn't chase you. Anyway. So, today's discussion is going based off of a I was watching the Hold Back to Block documentary on Killer Instinct. It's a great watch. You guys should watch it. It's about an hour and 45 minutes long. I have it pulled up here for a specific bit, which is what I'm going to touch on. So Keits, for you all who know who he is one of the combat designers of Killer Instinct and in Iron Galaxy. He made a bit, he made a statement in the documentary that kind of opened my eyes to like game balance. So like, you know how we all do, or some of the scrubs do. We see there's some cheap shit in the game, you know, we say, oh, just nerf it. That shouldn't be there. So like, don't mind that. So like, let's say Rashid, for example. Rashid literally does whatever the hell he wants, right? Like crouching hard punch, crush counter, can't really do nothing about it, you know. He has a lot of good ways to get in, all that stuff. So what bringing back to my point is that what Keats ran into, what he says is, his analogy was, instead of treating the symptoms, find the disease. So what they did was they found a problem with one character. In this case, it was Jago. Jago had no real weaknesses on any part of the screen. Up close, he was really good. Far away, he was really good. Mid-range, he was kind of meh, but the fact that he had wind kick, which was his, you know, spin kick, brought him right to your face. What happens is it was safe and it was automatically in your face and your opponent could not do nothing about it. So instead of nerfing, what the community got mad about was that they wanted the healing nerfed. Because in season one of Killer Instinct, if Jago popped instinct, he would heal over time. Now it's changed to where, okay, if he's an instinct and he throws fireballs, then he gains his healing, right? So they still wanted that nerf. They felt like he gained too much life back. But Keats was like, okay, well, we're gonna nerf this instead because this is now a weakness. If he has no weaknesses on anywhere on the screen, he's gonna always get in and get his health back some way, somehow. So what we're gonna do is, instead of having me explain it, we're gonna have Keats explain it. So I have the video pulled up. It's just this segment. Again, I really want everyone to go and watch this documentary. So it's Hold Back. It's called Fight On. It's by Hold Back to Block. Please go check this out. This is a really, really good watch, especially if you're like a Killer Instinct fan. And then if you're into games like this, it's so it's really a good watch. So what we're gonna do is, I'm gonna mute myself and we're just gonna give it a listen. So
and Microsoft's work on seasons 2 and 3 of Killer Instinct would bring more than just new characters to the series. Improved netcode, lighting, new music from Atlas Plug and Cell Dweller, and single player content like Shadow Lords would also be incorporated into the free to play title. Iron Galaxy also brought a change in balance philosophy to the game, taking a much more active approach to the method than most other fighting game developers at the time.
Double Helix was very arcade philosophy. They're like, this is the game until next season. This is what you've got. And my philosophy is not like that at all. I think that, you know, I'm much more thinking about how things can be or in the future rather than how they were in the past. A lot of my influence at the table was saying, no, let's actually update this game constantly and let's not be apologetic about it. Let's tell the fans, listen, every time we add a new character to this game, we're upsetting the balance just by the nature of adding a new character. And things are gonna have to change every single patch that we add a character, because now we have to see how this character stacks against all the existing characters. And this problem is exponential. this is a much more complicated problem on character 30 than it was on character 9. And you have to get the players on board with that idea that this is going to be a constantly shifting ecosystem.
It's really hard to find a fighting game that launches first and it, like, that is like stands the test of time good. It's always fun when you're exploring the system, but inevitably, pretty much every game, they have really game-breaking characters and game-breaking bugs. And I think KI Season 1 ended up being no exception to that.
Looking back on it, the game was just incredibly broken. Like, there was like so much, for lack of a better term, BS in the game that it was like, if you weren't playing Saber Wolf or Sidira, it was kind of hard to win because Saber Wolf having a zero frame shadow move that he can corpse dash and cross you up with it immediately, and if you weren't preemptively blocking, you were getting hit. And then Sidira having the best unbreakable combo in the game, so it was really hard to deal with.
One of the main disadvantages of Season 1 was that the breaker game actually ended up not mattering that much.
Combos in KI are like the big thing about it, right? When you get a hit, you get this combo, and there's an interaction between both players. And in Season 1, the way you would do combos most of the time is you would start the combo, do anything, the smallest, teeniest bit of a combo, and then do like a shadow ender to end the combo, and you did like 35% every time. So like, why would you even extend the combo at all if you could just take this free, like, big chunk of damage? So if you go back and watch the KI Top 8, the very first year was at EVO 2014, like, all the combos are like, just like, one hit, one chance, end the combo, 35% knockdown, like, what happened?
Fighting games are really hard to make. And you may release something that you think, like, this is the way that I think it's gonna be played, and then people get their hands on it, and they play it in ways that you never imagined. So one of the things that we really wanted to do was make sure that Killer Instinct stayed true to the two-way interaction. So we had to make sure that if you're doing something to somebody, that person should be able to do something in return, and you should also be able to react to that as well. And that game of constantly playing chess at full speed at all times, that two-way interaction was the thing that we wanted to touch on the most.
In KI, you can't really hide from your gut reaction. When you have a reaction to something, like, it's very common in KI when you talk to players, and they're like, I don't know why I broke there, I knew it was a bad idea, and I just couldn't stop my hands. Like, my hand, like, I just couldn't stop them. I find that a fascinating side of fighting game design, where players have this instinctive thing that they do. Like, I'm a very reserved player, for example, and other players are like, you know, balls to the wall, like, super aggressive, and it shows in the break game. It shows that they guess early, it shows that they can't be conditioned to stop breaking. Other players will never break, or like very rarely break.
Very smart with the overshield, he's able to
counter breaker
three times. Will Nicky stop? I cannot believe.
This sort of reservedness and aggression, this doesn't come out in a lot of other fighting games. AI brings it out of you in spades. You have no choice but to bury yourself in front of your opponent and engage in all the nasty sides of your fighting game habits that you don't want to explore to them. You don't want to show them that, you know, yeah, if you do this to me, I'm just going to die every time. I'm sorry, I can't stop it, I'm not that good. I think a lot of fighting game players in Season 2 who are used to games that didn't do that, you know, oh, I could hide from my bad habits here. I don't have to play this side of the game if I don't want to. In KI Season 2, they tried to make you play that game. And for me, there's just so much more richness there that I really liked it. And other players who wanted to avoid that because they wanted to like their stability, guaranteed damage with broken characters, they didn't like it.
As far as KI community goes, it was maybe a failed experiment. There's always been this wall between players and the developers. It's partially a language barrier thing because, you know, a lot of the players here are dealing with Japanese devs and it's just impossible to communicate. And of course, back in the day, we didn't have social media. We didn't have developers that had a social media presence, so you couldn't go knock directly on their door. You always had to go through a community manager if you wanted your feedback heard. So the experiment that I really wanted to try when they made me lead combat designer was to go out on Twitter, you know, with my meager following and say, yes, I'm the lead combat designer, let's have a dialogue. And be part of the community and show up to tournaments and play against top players, you know, in casual stations. You know, instead of having the live streams for character reveals and balance reveals be showed off by community managers, what if the combat design team was on the couch doing it? And we could really explain ourselves and really talk to people about not only what we did, but why we did it. I call it a failed experiment because what I think it ended up doing was also poisoning the well in a kind of way. It kind of spoiled people. There were definitely a group of players who considered themselves top players who became more interested in influencing the development of the game than they became interested in solving the game and being great at it. And that resulted in a lot of ultra negativity, a lot of, you know, kind of rallying their fans to kind of become a bandwagon of kind of hatred and negativity towards the developers, towards our balance choices. So that was a pretty crazy adventure. I think I learned a lot about it, about how to approach balancing games. I think my views on how to do it basically 180'd from the beginning of KI to the end. And I also learned a lot about how to decipher kind of the code of group speak. I'm gonna give you a great example of this. A lot of people are really mad at a certain thing, and they're rallying together to be mad together because they want change, right? Jago is too strong. His healing is through the roof. I did all that damage, and now he's got it back. I'm pissed, Iron Galaxy, what gives, right? And I think, you know, maybe a less experienced developer would be like, I guess the healing's too much. They're all saying it's too much, let's reduce the healing. We did not do that. We instead took 4 months to really study Jago and figure out the root of the problem. We wanted to find the disease, not the symptom. Because we always had this feeling that the healing was a symptom. And when we really dug into it, we were like, okay, Jago doesn't have any bad matchups in the entire game. His worst matchup's a 5-5. Why is that? Jago's not weak anywhere on the screen, actually. He's only kind of weak mid-screen. He's really good full-screen and he's really good up close. But as soon as he's mid-screen, he has this magical move called the Wind Kick, where he's immediately in your face and he's only like -2. So he can immediately get out of his worst distance in any matchup and be at his best distance. So we nerfed Wind Kick frame advantage. We didn't nerf the healing. We said, okay, medium and heavy Wind Kicks are more minus now. The heavy one's punishable, the medium one is sometimes punishable. And we told people why we did it in the patch notes, and they hated it. They all erupted. This is not what we asked for. We wanted you to nerf the healing. The healing is what was pissing us off. Why did you do this? Jago players are gonna have to rethink their game plan now, so they're pissed too. Everyone's big mad. And then a month and a half later, no one was complaining about Jago anymore. And new matchup charts were coming out, and Jago now had 4 or 5 bad matchups in the cast. Because we found the disease. The disease was that this character had no weakness on the screen. And I think developers really have to spend a lot of time trying to find the disease instead of listening to people crying about the symptoms, you know? Oh, my head hurts. Well, that could be a headache or a brain tumor. We have to really dig into it and find out what the problem is and make smart choices that will keep the entire ecosystem kind of in harmony.
For me, KI kept getting better.
So with that, I know that was pretty long. So with that, right? So instead of nerfing the healing, they nerf, you know, the fact that he can get in anywhere, right? Like, he had no matchup, bad matchup. If his worst matchup was a 5-5, okay, why is that, right? So, G is a symptom. That's why he's not getting nerfed. So, you're saying G is the problem? I bet G is a disease. Okay, so, like I said, with that, now that you guys kind of heard it from him, that's why this kind of thinking got me, like, got my head tilted, got me, like, you know, thinking about how we can go about, you know, changing stuff. So let's go ahead and not go there. Let's go ahead and where is it? Boop. As you can see, we have a lovable character here in the form of Akuma, because Akuma is damn near considered the strongest character in the game, if not top 2. So, and Wolfpack, to answer your question, yes, this is the stream where you can complain about Akuma, because this is the character we're going to talk about. If anyone else got any other characters, like, I want to talk about Rashid, I want to talk about maybe Urien and all that stuff. So, with this being said, right, we all know Akuma, right? Rashid broke. All right, so we all know Akuma, right? Akuma got the... I gotta do this with my pad so I don't feel like bringing up my stick. So Akuma, he's got a 3-frame jab. He's got the air fireball. He's got a medium DP. He's got an EX DP. You know, good back walk speed, good forward walk speed, good back dashes, good forward dash. You know, good combos. You know, frame traps. Plus, this is +3 on block. It's +1. This is damn near, you can't do shit about it. Shit, ridiculous, whatever, right? So, Akuma. I also have here is a handy-dandy word pad titled Cheap-Ass Akuma. So, for the people here, just make Kuma's health actually low, make it 300, buff the neutral tools. All right, so here's the list, right? I didn't really like go through it, so we have this, right? Cheap ass Akuma, big ass character. So for those who are here and are willing to say stuff, other than the walk speed, what do you believe are the pros of Akuma? Like I want to have this discussion. What are his good tools? Demon flip, right? Demon flip. And I said walk speed, crouch medium punch, fireball game. I'll say fireball game. He has AADP, EXDP, well, invincible, invol DP. Back heart punch, 3-frame jab. Three frame jab. Furthest in game. Stand medium kick. We have a lot of pros here, right? Air FB, two good VTs, confirmable crouch MK, corner pressure. Yes, corner pressure, good frame data. I'm not even going to say good. That kind of cuts it short. Great frame data. Crush kind of buttons are too strong. I'll say that. CC buttons. Well, I'm not going to say CC buttons. I'm going to say priority buttons. Because he has a lot of good priority. Say good priority. Good priority. Not too strong, just strong, right? Crouch HP being plus, right? Good priority. I'm gonna say mid screen pressure. This is a lot. This man got a lot of shit. Easy mode, side switch. Yep, I was just going to say that. Mid-screen tick throws. Yep, mid-screen pressure. Yep. So, is this everything? This is about it? He has good walk speed, demon flip, crouch medium punch, fireball game, AADP, invulnerable DP, back hard punch. A 3-frame jab is the furthest in the game. Stand medium kick, air fireball. Two good V triggers, confirmable crouching medium kick, corner pressure, great frame data, good priority, mid screen pressure, easy mode side switch, dive kick. Wouldn't that go under demon flip anyway? I just put that under demon flip. Good CA, that's a really good one. Good CA. Cause I don't think the normal dive kick is that great. I said the ridiculous V trigger already. It's right here. Two good VTs. Like VT1 is amazing. VT2 is all right. You know. Beats out her anti-air clean. Yes, that's very true. All right. So, these are all the pros, right? Most of the pros, we can say, right? So these are all the pros, or most of the pros. Let's talk about the cons, right? And I think we all know, like, one con, right? If you want to call it that. What does he have? 900 health? Is it 900? Okay. Pressure lost after forward throw. But anyway, isn't that most characters though? Isn't that most characters? So pressure loss after forward throw. Any other cons for this character? Like, I mean, I know people are saying health don't matter, but that's what we're gonna get into that. So 900 health, pressure lost after forward throw. He has low stun. You're right. He has low stun. Oh, did I say damage? I'm gonna say great damage, stun. This Akuma? Yes, this is Akuma Sky Guy. We're trying to find the pros and cons of playing Akuma. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, I know, like, no one really gets it, right? So I don't know if I should really think about adding this, but I'll leave it here for now. He's a Shoto. That's a how is that a con? He has to spend time in characters like thinking about which graphic trigger to use. I guess. I mean, I don't know. What do you guys think? Is there any more cons for this character? Difficulty? I don't think Akuma's that hard to use. I don't think he's that hard to use. He can't combo into demon. Up close fireball, bad on block. But then again, if you up close. Yeah, that's bad. That's bad for most of the cast, though, right? The up close fireball. He's not autopilot. I mean, is that a con, though? Just saying, right? Okay. What I want for cons is like something that, you know, that he has, that he struggles with, something that he only, you know, that he struggles with a lot. Like, he has second or the lowest health in the game. You know, he has low stun, if not the lowest stun. So we're just trying to figure this out. So like, he isn't as cool as Kage. So, I mean, if this is it, then this is it. We don't have to keep looking for it. Like, I mean, like I said, his fireball game's good. Yeah, they're bad on block, but I mean, that's, I think, most of the cast anyway. I think other than, you know, other than maybe Yurian, you know? Yurian and maybe Jury, who can make their shit safe or plus. Does have a ton of reach. That is, I wouldn't say, is he stubby? I mean, that's what I'm saying. It's like, even if he was stubby, it doesn't matter because his priority matters more. It's the, okay, that makes sense. So, okay, I mean, yeah. I'll say slightly stubby. Slightly. slightly stubby. I'll say slightly stubby. Because stand medium kick is pretty damn good. Crouching medium punch is pretty damn good. And jab being the furthest three frame in the game is kind of bonkers. I honestly think this is it. Me personally, I think this is it. I don't think he really has no bad cons, right? I don't think he does. So let's see. So now we're done doing that, right? Where's my pad? He doesn't have a long range normal. Okay, so get over here. Save this, put here. So that way we're here, right? So now, like I said, let's go up to his pros. So we said walk speed, pretty goddamn good, right? Demon flip, pretty fucking annoying. I seen a fucking setup to where this dude was just fucking, like, he swept or some shit. Like, he got the knockdown, did this, and I had no idea what side he was on. Crouch medium punch, really good. Hits kind of far. It's really good priority. It's plus on block. Combos into this. Into stand medium kick, which is pretty damn good. You can just do this. Back into some Oki. You know, yada, yada, yada. What do we say? Fireball game. Fireball's pretty good. If they're up close, you know, set something back to neutral. If they're up close, knock down into the same shit. You know, that's not what I did. AADP, the invincible DP, back hard punch, because why not? Right? Why not? Good frame traps. I forgot to say that too. So, like, because this shit is ridiculous. This three frame jab, furthest in the game. Like, that shit is ridiculous. Stand medium kick, right? So, stand medium kick. It's -4, right? But at this range, you're not punishing it. Like, at this range, you're not really punishing it. And he doesn't even have to commit to it. So, if you press here, that's a frame trap. That's a frame trap. That right there. It sets this up. You know what I mean? Just character is just pretty damn strong, right? But he dies fast. You know what I mean? You know, he has air fireball. Really, really strong V-trigger. This shit, you know, demon or whatever the fuck. You know, it's just a really strong character. So, with this in mind, right? What do you guys think is the problem? What do you guys honestly think is the problem? So let's go on to our notepad. And let's talk about this. Oops. So what's the problem? Or what is the disease? Let's say that. What is the disease? 20 strengths, 3 weaknesses. Too safe for low health with good anti-air buttons. The disease is the Satsui no Hado. Alright. So let's see. Realistically, it's his air options. Okay, so we'll say air options. That's one. That's one disease, right? Or a potential disease. His defensive tools completely mitigate his glass cannon class. I like that idea. Defensive options. Mitigate glass cannon. He has too many tools. Okay, too many tools. Best thing, the bad fireballs aren't, you know, the fireballs aren't bad. Yes, yeah, it's still something you gotta deal with. Right? So with these four things, air options, defensive options, and too many tools, what of these pros would you consider changing the most? So we'll go through it again. Walk speed, demon flip, crouch medium punch, fireball game, the AADP, the invincible DP, back hard punch, the three frame jab, stand medium kick, air fireball, the V triggers, his confirmable crouching medium punch, his corner pressure, his great frame data, good priority, his mid screen pressure, his easy mode side switch, his CA, or his damage and stun. So me personally, I think nerfing this, nerfing stand medium kick to not for stand. I think nerfing this to not for stand would be great. Because if they didn't stand, right? Because if it was like one of these, if they didn't for stand, this doesn't work. You know what I mean? This does not work. Which also, you know, that also cuts that, you know, because if that doesn't force stand, why can I not do this on pad? He doesn't get this, right? So now he doesn't have a, you know, a get out of jail free card or get out of jail free combo. And then puts you in a shitty situation, right? I think that would be what I'd do. I would nerf stand medium kick to only not force stand. Because this shit, they just do this, and you just happen to be like crouching or something. And sometimes they're just doing this. They don't care. You know, sometimes they'll just do it. And then this happens, right? Now you're in the same shitty situation. That's just me. So let's see. What you guys say? I just learned how to live with it. I'm okay with Akuma. I mean, Akuma, yeah. I'm fine with dealing with cheap-ass Akuma. I'm okay with it. But the exercise is to try and figure out what the problem is. Like, is it just too many tools? Nerf recovery of his air tools. Guard off. A safe? That's really safe. That's minus two. Wow. It's minus three. Minus one. Plus one. Jesus Christ. I don't want to take away what he is, but I think there's interesting ways to make him similar tools do different things. Right. I like that they change up the timing on how air fireballs works to make trades against more reliable. Right. EX. So, talking about this one? make this punishable. That man, I agree. Yeah, this is pretty stupid. That's pretty dumb. Right? Regulating that. So, if everyone's saying nerf that, right? So, nerf this so he can, so he nerf his recovery, right? Yeah, I understand that. The way his kit is set up is the way he's always set up to be great in any game. Like, he's not bad in any game except for the versus games. Other than that, he's still pretty goddamn good. You know what I mean? Even Marvel 3, actually, he was good. He was good in Marvel 3 because he was just so goddamn good. So, but my thing is, yeah, this, if you nerf this, Akumas will have to think whether or not, because if you're crouching, okay, I can't do this anymore. Can't do this. So I either do this, right? Or I do this. You know what I mean? It's still a shitty situation, right? But that's 170. You know what I mean? Oops, I'm fucking up. I can't do shit on pad. You know what I mean? This little bit here, it nerfs his damage. And two, you know what I mean? It just nerfs his options. Because then he gets more damage in the same shitty situation. This is the same situation for less damage. Sure, he gets a little bit, you know, more corner carry or whatever. This one, I think he loses everything. Yeah, he loses, right? Yep, on back tech, he loses. Look at all this. All because this forces stand. You know what I mean? All because that forces stand. Yeah, and Akuma is the only character that can... They nerfed it, but he's the only character that can still combo after his super. He's the only one. But that's not a big thing, right? That's just one of those... That's not a big thing. That's just... I would much rather him have that, right? That's something specific only to him. Because that's not that big of a deal. But... So, with this... What else? What else would I nerf? I would nerf this. This has no reason to be as good as it is. When he has anti-air jab, he has anti-air DP, he has this, you know, he can chaos control, do this, you know what I mean? Oh, but yeah, this does not need to be as good as it is, right? So I think the problem... The main problem is that, yeah, he has too many tools that are good. So it's hard to find what his actual, like, what the actual, like, disease is. Make it so it can't cancel? I think that's a little too much, honestly. What is? Honestly, make it so it can't cancel. What is our goal? Okay, so our goal is to find out what we can do, what, not what we can do, but what is the disease that makes Akuma so great? That's the goal here. We're trying to figure out what we can nerf without hurting the character, without killing him. What can we nerf? What can we change? Because right now he's strong. He has no real weaknesses. So what we're trying to do is find out what we can do to make him have a weakness. Because I don't think Akuma has many bad matchups. So like, we want him mid-tier, not necessarily mid-tier. We don't want, like, Jago's still good. Like, Jago, I think, is still top 5, 10. I'm not sure. But I would say make him reasonable. You know, give him something or take away something that makes him less of a burden to deal with. Because if he's good back here, you know, he's good over here. He can do this or boom. And do that in your face. You know what I mean? Yeah, I think I agree in a sense. Having a ton of tools isn't bad, but the fact all of his tools are great and work in such tandem with each other means it's rare. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He has so many tools that are good that everything just works. You know what I mean? So, like, back hard punch. That's not what I want to do. Back hard punch this shit. It combos. You know. That's not that good. Into this shit. You know, it's a lot. He has so much. So, again, I'm not trying to take away something. I'm trying to normalize him. What can we do to normalize Akuma? Like, would it be nerfing the range on his stand jab? Making it 4 frames? You know what I mean? Annoying. Yeah. You have to take something away. So what are we going to take away? Like, we can keep all of his normals. We can keep... But what are we going to make bad, essentially? What are we going to make slightly worse or worse? What are we going to do? What is the best way to go about this? Right? That's what I'm trying to figure out. Because, like I said, they didn't... Like, with Jago, they didn't make... They didn't nerf the healing completely. They just didn't... They nerfed something because he had a weakness where if he had a weakness where he was in his bad range, he was in there. No knockdown on fireball? I like that. But then again, that doesn't take this away. Right? His fireball game is still good, and most times, most Akumas aren't going to do this. So actually, what we can do, I'll put that in. I'm gonna fireball, no knockdown. Introduce a bad range. So nerf his walk speed. Nerf walk speed. I was thinking that too. Nerf walk speed. This man's fast. This man's literally on roller skates. I think knockdown fireball would be a good nerf. Yeah. Cause then my thing is this, that works in tandem with this, right? So if this doesn't force standing, let me put that there. So if this doesn't force standing, they have that. Right? So now, this, you get less damage. Yeah, they can still MK Tatsu. Yeah, but then again, I would much rather eat the Tatsu, right? Than this shit for 170? I would much rather eat the Tatsu. Cause this 162. This 170. This 170. You know what I mean? It's still the same situation, but now this doesn't happen. Look, like, this little bit of damage, this shit adds up because stun. You know what I mean? And then he can do shit like this. It's ridiculous. This would actually kill the character? That's bogus. This not forcing standing would kill him? That's a lot. There's no way. There's no way. Cause then, his crouchers? They can do this for a bar. Right? They can do that for a bar, but they lose everything. You see what I mean? This one change, it doesn't kill him, it normalizes him. Chain the knee to a 7-frame move and 5-frame and 5 MP into a 5-framer would be a... This? Isn't this... 5 frames? You want this 5 frames? This shit is already good. I actually, you know what? I think if you're nerfing this, you should buff this. Oh, this into 5 frames. Make this 5 frames? Sure. Sure. That's fair. That's way too long to be 5 frames. Because Jury Stand Medium Kick, it's 5 frames, but it doesn't reach all the way out here. The second hit reaches all the way out here, and that's 7 frames. That's too far. Yeah, I agree. I agree with top left center. This is way too long to be a 5-frame normal. Knee is just about as long. I wouldn't say that. This is a lot longer than this. It's just this one you can't really do anything about because it's 5 frames. If anything, I think this has the same range, if not a little bit more, than Jury Stand Medium Kick. And that's long, but it's not that long. This is pretty long for a 5-frame normal. Let's see. I don't think Akuma's normals are anything that really makes him OD. The only normal I would touch is Crouch Hard Punch. This? You would change it to what? Because I know you said something about this being plus, right? This is what, plus 2? Plus 3? Yeah. What would you want this change, BDN? I'd say make this plus 1. Instead of plus 3? That's just me, though. I'd say make this plus 1. Because this shit, it's a priority normal. Pretty damn absurd. It has good range. Look at how far this shit hits. Granted, on a crouching opponent, but eh. Switching the frame data would keep the neutral tool of the four-standing knee while not allowing the bogus shit on his standard B&Bs. It's a set same exact as Nash's, except that crush counters and converts anything, any range. That's true. This? Yeah. So what do you guys say about this, right? What we do about this, right? Because that would nerf this, his up-close game, right? I think I think the thing is that he's so, like, most of his mid-range is really good, and they all, like, do the exact same thing, which is this. Keep it plus but not have it CC, or make it minus and have it still CC. Make crouching hard punch minus but still CC, or keep it plus but don't, but no CC. I like that idea. Yeah, you can toss it out neutral. This button transcends time and space. Do whatever the fuck he wants. You ever see Alive by 7 Blank? No. Man's lives and dies by that button. I agree. Okay, so there's that, right? Crouching hard punch. So they got rid of this, right? This. The V trigger cancel. That's fair, right? That shit did not need to be in the game. So what else? You know? People are saying, mate, that's way too long to be 5 frames. That shit would have all the priority. Fuck this button. Just use this. If that's 5 frames, fuck this. That's too damn far. You can whip punish anything. Yeah, stand me on punch is fine, I think. I think stand me on punch is fine. Plus one. You know. Let's see. Anything else? You guys said nerf air fireball recovery, right? So if his normal fireball doesn't no longer knocks down, he has a nerfed walk speed. This doesn't force stand. This is either plus but no CC or minus and still CCs, and nerf his fireball recovery. If there's any more things we should change, I'm all ears. Oh, back hard punch. Yeah, I know none of these things are going to happen. It's not going to happen. He said access denied. So, what should we do with back hard punch? Should we just make it one hit instead of two? Should we nerf the height on it? Should we give it the back? I think we should give it the back medium punch treatment, like Cammy's, where it doesn't hit cross ups. Shorten the hitbox. Okay. I wish I had. Wish you should look at frame or not hitboxes on PS4. Cancel on the first hit only. That's not a bad idea, but the thing, well, actually, that's a good idea. If you make this cancelable on first hit only, how good is this? How good is the first hit in the air? No. I think that was the second hit. Yeah. Back HP is fine. Just as an anti-air. So, here's what I'm thinking. So either we make back hard punch cancelable on first hit only, or we shorten hitbox of second hit. Right, make it a normal hitbox and shouldn't hit cross up. Right, I agree. I do agree. He gets too much damage off of it. The reward is fine. The reward is fine from this? From this? All this is fine? Well, you know what? Actually, I have a better idea. Make back fierce one hit. And it's just this. It's just the second hit. You can still have it be cancelable. It can still be an anti-air, because that's what it's used for. That's what it's used for, right? That. That's okay. I agree. I do agree that if you take this away, then this might kill the character. Taking this away, that kind of kills him. But if you make it one hit, which is just this, I think that's fine. Saying hard punch doesn't bother me that much. There's a lot of characters that get stupid okie damage off relatively easy anti-airs, right? Right. But I'm just saying, in terms of like, if what else we can take. So like, since this is only used as an anti-air, you're never going to see the first hit, because most cheap-ass Akumas will do shit like this, right? They'll do this. Right? Or, you know, some dumb shit, right? I honestly say make it one hit. Right. You interrupt the heavy version, right? Which is fine, right? But what I'm saying is, if you get rid of this first hit, right? This would just be used as an anti-air. You know what I mean? Some people, yeah, like Tao said, some people just do this. They don't give a damn. Because, where is it at? Let me look at FAT real quick. I think it's pretty slow. Akuma. Okay, so this is 6 frames? Jesus Christ. This is really 6 frames? What the fuck? What the fuck? They really did, this is 6 frames. They really made this shit 6 frames. So he has a cami button. Oh, that's cheap. That's cheap. What's the startup of the second hit, though? Probably doesn't matter. But I honestly, like, honestly, I mean, do they do? They don't really. I ran into some. But I think that's just because they're looking for the anti-air. Yeah. But what I'm trying, we're trying to get rid, like, I'm trying to make him have a bad matchup. But at the same time, we have to look and see what the problems are, what are we trying to fix, and see what could be a bad matchup at this point. So I'm trying to do this in, like, that kind of way. So figure out what his problems are, figure out what his strengths are, figure out what his problems are, what can we do, what are we finding that can be led, that we can lead into him having a bad matchup. You know? They think Sagat is a bad matchup? Really? What? How is that a bad matchup? I mean, yeah, Sagat does big dick damage, but you're constantly in his face. He can't do shit. Birdie's a bad matchup? I can see that, but Birdie... Well, wait, Birdie now or Birdie then? Because I can still see Birdie still being a bad matchup. But even then, that's not that bad. Zach saying it's not that easy to get in as well as the hard hitter. I still firmly believe that making back hard punch one hit. I think that would be good, because he still gets his cancel. He still gets his cancel. He still keeps his anti-air. That first one, the first hit just doesn't exist anymore, because it's just, because this is kind of unnecessary. Like, this is just unnecessary. This he doesn't need. I don't think he needs that. And as well as Sagat, I take the throw, and Akuma has to work to get in. Yeah, I don't think that's a bad matchup, though. Sagat, Akuma, bad matchup? I mean, I don't think anyone wins the fireball war against Sagat other than maybe Guile. I don't think Sagat's a bad matchup for Akuma. Yeah, it's rough, but that don't mean it's a bad matchup. It's rough. Like, you can have a favorable matchup and it still be rough. It still be annoying. Like, I think Jiri beats Dawson 5.5 or even 6.4. It's still annoying for me to deal with. That just because it's a rough matchup doesn't mean, I mean, not a rough matchup, just because it's rough getting in doesn't mean it's a bad matchup. You know what I mean? Actually, I don't even need this on. Why is it still on my head? My head is hot. So, all right. Close fireball doesn't knock down. Nerf his walk speed. make this minus but still CC, or keep it plus but no CC. Nerf the recovery, make this one hit. Well, I'm gonna say AA only. Cause he still gets his reward, right? He would still get his reward off that, right? He'll still get it. No question, right? This doesn't force stand. Alright. So, with all these tools, with most of the stuff that we have so far as a solution. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They only do this for the AA anyways, unless they're being cheeky and doing this shit, right? That's really it. So yeah, he doesn't need to have the second hit. He doesn't need to have an insurance policy for this shit, right? Doesn't need to have an insurance policy. Actually, let me see some shit. That shit plus. That shit don't make no damn sense. Hard knockdown on DP is retarded. On this? Yeah, he should keep this. He should keep this. Just for the fact that it's just, you know, it's specific to only him, right? He should keep that. If they got rid of this, that'd kind of be stupid. With the air fiber recovery, that should go into this. You know what I mean? The timer on the V trigger. That shit do go down pretty damn slow. That shit does go down pretty goddamn slow. Whoops. Damn it. I cannot do shit on pad. How many fireballs can he throw? 1, 2, 3, 4. He can throw 4. 1, 2, 3. You say you'd call stand medium kick, not forcing this? Make VT1 two bars and give him only half the time. Make VT1 two bars, but give him half the time. No. That's a good one. Actually, hold on. That's a good one. I'll think about that one. No, that's a. Yeah, but yeah, that's what I'm saying. So like, if you cut the time, right? But making this two bar, okay. Don't do that. Let's see. So let's go to a different character, right? Actually, let's do this instead, because I think Jury has a good. She has a good one. actually, let's do this instead. So, let's see something. Ah, fucked up. So, let's see something. I just want to see something. They both go down really slow, but yeah, Akuma's goes down way slower. So, this is actually making me think a little bit. I actually like this idea. I like cutting his time, but making it two bars. Let me scroll up. I missed some stuff. Hang on. You'd have to remove the ability. He gets one air fireball, then it's done. That's fucked up, BDN. He gets one air fireball, that's it. That's fucked up. Can you imagine Akuma popping BT? Alright, I'm about to get started. Psych. Can you imagine that shit? They would be so pissed. That's what making it two bars done? Yeah, but even then, like when Jury does hers, right? Like, hers is two bars. Look how much. It, like, damn near filled it up, right? You're already half. What's up, Carlos? Play some matches? I don't feel like playing. I'm in a thinking mood. That's why I'm doing this. He said, what? I'm in a thinking mood. I watched something. I'm thinking. This is a good discussion. Oops, I don't want that to happen. Basically half. Was it? Yeah, you're right. So you would keep his VT the same? Whoops. You would really keep his VT the same. And if he does his HK Tots to... Whoops. That's horrible. He got a scale combo into no more V trigger. After one fire, he was basically half. And then if he does... So you're saying he should do this? And then this, and that's it. Is that what you're saying, BDN? He can get one air fireball and one DP. So, if that's the case, one, two... That means he would get three of those. Maybe two. That's all he basically gets anyways. I'm saying keep his B-trigger the same. Well, that's not really all he gets. I mean, he still keeps it, right? Around this point, you might, yeah, they're gonna do that. Keep VT1 the same. Oh yeah, well if that's the case and you make that two bars, so he gets this. He gets this combo. He doesn't have B trigger anymore. He can just immediately start building it back up. Okay. Nerf his stun output. Nerf his stun output. But everyone got stun buffs, right? Or most of the cast got a stun buff. This shit hit mad far. That shit is far. That shit is really fucking far. Okay. Fireball, no knockdown. So, what is it on hit then? Plus 12. Oh, he's minus 1. Minus 1, so he would lose his turn after that. You're right. Okay, that makes sense. But you don't want it to be minus on hit though, right? You don't want it to be Ken. So yeah, that normal fireball, no knockdown. That's fair. Nerf walk speed. Honestly, I keep his walk speed the same. I think his walk speed is fine. Especially if we're gonna give him other different shit that we're gonna change. I think the problem is that like most people said, most of his shit, they just work. Everything just works. You know what I mean? I don't think that should work, honestly. So to insinuate that weakness, you make him have to spend longer killing people. That makes sense. Akuma is just super complete compared. Yeah, that's very true. He's just super complete. Everything just works. And just delete them, problem solved. I respect that. So, he could be amazing or dog shit. I won't say he'd be dog shit because, I mean, with this, not with that, but with this, he'd still be like an asshole to deal with, right? Like, that's something you have to, like, take. And yeah, Akuma, no matter what, just the way his kit works, just the way his special moves are set up, he's going to be amazing. Sim is an asshole, not good. I just think Akuma needs back nerf, EX air fireball nerfed, crouch hard part nerf, can be debated. That's it. Oops. I think they should. God damn, I can't do shit on pad. Oh my goodness. So, what did you say, BDN, about EX Air Fireball? Has no recovery. It's true. Even more recovery. So you sneak under, right? JGZ, thanks for the follow, bro. You are now a vital follower. I appreciate you. What is this on with? Demon flips in general have low recovery, hard to punish. Yeah, but I think having this though, like this having low recovery is fine. This having low recovery is okay. Because the thing that beats that is like DPs or air throws. Reduce the speed. Like the speed of the startup or while he's already in the air. That shit dumb. Nerf the speed of the startup. And I would say keep EX. Oh shit. I would say keep EX the same. I would keep EX the same. Because you're already spending a bar for it. Think demon flip is fine. That's what I was saying too. I think demon flip is fine because you can DP it. Like, yeah, this is that baits DPs. This you can DP it, or if you have an air throw, you can air throw it. What about this? What about the pushback of Fireball VT1? Yeah, they're plus one, right? I don't want to do that. So that's real. So like this. So Fireball jab is real. Do you think there should be some pushback on it? That's fine. Okay. I was just saying. This is fine. All right. If people believe that's fine, that's fine. Y'all think that's fine? That's fine. So this messes with his corner game. He still has this though. I think this is fine. I think that's fine. Yeah, for four framers, this sucks, right? This shit sucks, cause you can't do nothing about it. That shit is trash. Yeah, fine at plus one. I think that's fair. Yeah, cause yeah, it sucks for four framers that you gotta deal with that shit, but I honestly think that's fine. I don't like the fact that we can whiff punish with stem, meme, kick, EX fireball, the dash, EXDP. That he can whiff punish this? Oh, then dash, EXDP. Oh. This. Yeah, I know what you mean. Mid-screen, he can do that. Yeah, that's two bars. That's something he gotta do. He wastes for that. And I personally think that's fine. So like this shit. Goddamn, why do I suck on pad? Oh my god, I can't do anything. Yeah, that's fine. That's two bars, not a lot of damage. He doesn't get any Oki. I think that's fine. I think they should get rid of this. The guaranteed fire damage. Well, no. Does Kage have that too? Corey, are you here? Does Kage have the fire damage? No. Is it just Akuma? You can view reversal it too? What do you mean? What do you mean you can view reversal it? Oh my god, I cannot do shit right. You can view reversal. View reversal Kage's, but not Akuma? What do you mean? Let me see. That's the wrong one. Fuck me. Where did it go? Oh, it's number five. Oh my god. Jury, please. You mean the first hit? Hold on. That's stupid. This is that. That's dumb. That's dumb. You can reverse Kage the fireball on startup active frames, but not Akuma's when you're in the corner. This is dumb. You said you can do that to Kage's? Am I doing something wrong? What is this? Plus 84, Jesus Christ. Maybe you're tripping? Maybe you are, because did that pretty consistently. Let me try one more time. Maybe I'm delaying it too much. Okay, there's 0.2. It seems like you can't do that either. Oops, I fucked up. Counter. Oh, I see. I see what you mean. So if it's an early view, if it's an on-point view reversal, no, it's not a spacing thing. So if it's an on-point view reversal, Kage can't grab. If it's slightly late, like, cause I had it at 0.3 earlier. Damn, it's 3. What the fuck am I doing? Now that's 1, right? This is what I wanted anyway. This is what I wanted in the beginning. So this is 0.1, so this is an immediate view reversal. Can't do anything. So let's go to Akuma before I change it back. So that's an immediate view reversal. I think what Corey means is that if it's an immediate view reversal, you can't do anything about it. I think that's what he means. Cause that shit is kinda dumb. That shit kinda dummy. So boop. Yep. Oh my god, Kage can't do it. Yeah, that's what it is. Kage cannot do it. That's an immediate view reversal. Now that was the normal one, right? Yep. So Akuma's EX Fireball is you might as well just sit there and take it. And what is it on block? Plus 8. That's ridiculous. Yeah, he just gets the burn damage, but now he's plus 8 in your face. Be reversible. So I wouldn't. What is this on block? This is minus 4. From minus 4 to plus 8, that's a bit much. I plus three. I'd make it plus three. I'd make that plus three. Because plus eight is pretty goddamn ridiculous. That's pretty fucking ridiculous. I had no idea this was plus eight and non-universal. That's ridiculous. Because, yeah, that is just dumber. You know what I mean? Because now you're eating that, and if you don't react to it, you're he's plus eight in your face, dog. All right. So going by all this shit, right? He has a lot of pros, not enough cons. We have pretty much decided that his air options and he has too many tools, right? Way too many that are like they're in conjunction with each other. Like everything works for air, like for any situation. So I firmly believe that we should keep this, like make this change. We should make this change. I said we make this change too. This is ridiculous. EX red fireball is fine. I mean, my thing is this, right? So, like, if you go from, what, minus 6 to minus 4 to minus 4, then to plus 8 with additional burn damage and chip, I don't think that's fair. But, again, that's probably something that he should keep, but I don't know, like, I'm trying to figure out what it is, right? I think it's just this, you know, this game right here. In the corner, everything is just here, right? Everything works. All you're gonna do is grab after. I mean, yeah, but then, right, if you grab, like if he grabs, yeah, that beats your universal. But then, yeah, you're taking a throw, but now you're eating just random chip damage for a bar and it's plus 8. Burn and chip, excuse me. I think making it plus 3 is fair. I think making it plus 3 is fair. It can still be plus. But making it, you know, whatever. Because he can still grab you, right? But then that means you can V-reversal out of it. Because I think the reason why you can't V-reversal out of it is because it's plus 8. So if you make it plus 3, he has to... At that point, okay, are you going to be reversal? That means, okay, you spent your bar, and I'm taking my defense back. And he had, you know, not defense, but you're trying to defend and lower your stun. Does this cost stun? No. You can jump out or jab it. Is that 3-frame jab or 4 frames? You can 4-frame. Get your cheat. Okay. But at the same time, though, well, actually, yeah, it wouldn't matter at that point. I mean, you still get the gray damage. It's not as much, I don't think. Yes, you still get the gray. You still eat the gray damage, right? I don't know. I think just this not being, you not able to view reversal is kind of dumb. I think that's kind of unfair. You should be able to view reversal out of that. What's, hold on. Well, Kage's is plus six, but you can view, see? But you can view reversal it. Make it plus, we'll make it plus six. Make it the same as Kage's. Make it the exact same. Make it the exact same, because if all they're going to do is throw you, that gives the defender a chance to, okay, I'm going to view reversal, and then if you throw me, you know, you get hit, I'm out. Can he give you? Oh, it's only on. It's only when they're standing. Yeah, it's only when they're recovering. Well, only when they're like standing up. Okay. I think Kage has more pushback too. It might. I think it does. Anything besides a super preventing you from doing a view reversal seems busted. Reversals are already weak. I mean, that doesn't really matter to Akuma because his super is one hit. So even then, that's still an shitty situation for anyone. I don't know. Everyone's good at this range, so I can't really take that away from him. I think just the fact that he's good everywhere else. So like, yeah, this. Yeah, actually. Just make this worse. Make this not four stand mid screen. Or just not make it four stand at all. If you don't make it four stand, Akuma's gotta think. And then there's that, right? And it puts you in the corner. The fireball recoveries, I agree. Cause yeah, there are times where I do this, where Akumas will do this. I dash under it or whatever, and I feel like I can't punish them. That's pretty fair. Make this only AA, cause that's what it actually is. Fix the hurt box on it. BDN, you said shorten it, right? If you're still here. Not hurt box, hit box. No. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, give it the back. Give it the back. Medium punch streamer for like Cammy. That's what I was saying too. Just give it the back. Medium punch streamer. And I really can't DP on pad. I know that word. There we go. Got all that goddamn damage. But I'll keep that. That's fair to him. That's fine. How much do I care about Akuma players? I don't care about Akuma players. Because they don't think. Most of them don't. I can't, honestly, I'm not, now this is not a jab against all the Akuma players, but I mean, this character does it all. Like, he does it all. So I say, yeah, nerf the walk speed, make these air fireballs more, have more recovery, EX one as well. What was the other ones? Let's see. Make this not force stand, because that's ridiculous. Because an Akuma could just do this, right? They could just, you know, what is this unblock? So, fucking counter hit, right? They just bop, whatever fucking dumb shit they do. They just wake up, jab, counter hit you, time to guess. That's dumb. And they're right on you. You know what I mean? I honestly think that is dumb. Granted, if your meaty is standing, okay, sure, you deserve it. You know what I mean? You deserve it. But like, I have a crouching 3-frame normal. Or sometimes I just want to use crouching jab, because it's 4 active frames. I don't want to get caught standing. You know what I mean? MK is fine? Are you serious? You really think this should 4 stand? I don't know. I don't think that should 4 stand. Because if I'm trying to play neutral and he does this, you know what I mean? Like, that's like I press crouch medium punch and I get hit standing, it's kind of OD. In my opinion, though. That's in my opinion. This, like... That's what I'm saying, like, instead of, like, nerfing, like, how slow it is or how fast it is, its recovery, just nerf the extra shit on it. Like, the standing. The force stand. I don't think that should be a thing. Because they can just do this, and it works anyway. It works damn near anywhere. And if they think they're too far, oh, well... Yeah, the B&Bs are fine only if they're already standing. If they're crouching, I don't think this should happen. You know what I mean? It makes Akumas have to think where they are, because they're just mindlessly doing this. And also the problem is when you're crouching, your hurt box is extended. So you hit someone crouching and you think you're too far away, you're really not. See what I mean? See? score right here. So she's at this line. Fuck. All right, her leg's on the line. Boop. Oops, not jump. Oops. No. It's a good butt. I don't know, man. I think force and stand is pretty. That's. Cause no one else has that, right? I don't think, anyway. And the thing is, the reward for Akuma is so good, right? It's so good for Akuma to have it force stand. Cause he can do one of two things, like side switch, massive corner carry into the same thing, and he's right on top of you. Maybe make demon flip palm go further, push you out further. I don't know. But you crouch hard punch for a stand. Ryu crouch and hard punch, that's a priority normal, but it has no range compared to this, though. Like, that has... That... I mean, I can see the argument, but at the same time, it's like, this is... 5 frames. Forces standing. Leads into damn near anything. You know what I mean? Right on top of her. I mean, I don't know. You know what I mean? I honestly don't know. No Akuma confirms that shit. Yeah, that's what I'm saying, though. Since they don't confirm it, it's just the fact that it can still do what it does, even if they're not confirming it, which means if they're just doing it, it's still gonna garner that result. You know what I mean? It's still gonna garner that result. I mean, like I said, I don't know. I'm just trying to find out in terms of like what now that we have all this stuff, what kind of bad matchup would he have now? I think he has rough matches. I don't think he has any bad ones. He has rough ones. I don't think he flat out loses a matchup. I think his worst matchup is 5-5. Yeah, like his walk speed should be his walk speed nerfed. The fireball's fine. Give this, yeah. Cause I think most of the stuff that we're keeping is like in terms of the mid range, right? Like, yeah, keep his walk speed, but if you give this more recovery, he would probably, like, only get, like, a light confirm or something, or it's easier to punish if you block it. A little bit easier. Make this one hit, because it's only being used as an AA anyway. Fix the hitbox, which is fine. Give this more recovery so you can punish it easier. and this is all his mid-range stuff, right? So I think he's really strong in the mid-range. Like, up close, he's fine. Far away, he's fine. But if you give him something to deal with here, that's where he struggles, right? I'm not going to say that's where he struggles at, because that's not where he struggles at. But this is where he would struggle at. Because now if we're here, and I'm losing the fireball war, okay, I'm going to jump in with an air fireball. Oh, wait, I have recovery now. So, you know, that's a risk in itself. Like, you still got to deal with the fireball. But if you give it recovery, yeah, sure. Bait the DP, sure. But then if it doesn't get baited out, they dash up, they dash under it, you get hit. Yeah, this is a mid-range button. It stops jumps. Stops this. A mid-range tool. I'd say make that plus 6. We'll make the X-rated fireball just like Kage. Oh no, though. So, I mean, I guess with that, I guess we're done. I mean, this isn't me screaming for nerfs. This isn't me doing anything. I'm just trying to figure out what could be done to make this character easier to deal with, because he has so much shit. He has so much shit. I'm trying to think about what all did they nerf throughout the years, and I can't seem to remember it right now. Like, I know they nerfed the They nerfed the red fireball V trigger shit. That's obnoxious. They nerfed that meme kick. What they do to it? Yeah, they nerfed demon flip, because this was what? Oh, shit, not that. This was what, plus 1 on block at one point in time, or plus 2 or some shit. Yeah, it used to be plus. Oh yeah, there's this. Yeah, he can't do that anymore. That's fine. So I think what they did was they slowed this down, right? Or they gave this more pushback. I think they gave this more pushback. That's. Come on, BDN. Come on, BDN. Come on, dog. Dude. Bruh, you come on, man. Come on. Come on, BD. This cannot force standing. You ain't know you can do this? This shit broken, bro. But that's what I'm saying, though. Since your crouching hurt box is extended, this shit can happen to you. Into that. Like, that is ridiculous. And that's for free. Like, you don't get that, but you get this. You know what I mean? You get two of these with this. Boom, 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 boom. Welcome to jail. That shit is ridiculous. This cannot force standing. Akuma got second lowest pool in the game, so let him get some cheap stuff. Lowest pool? What do you mean, lowest pool? If you nerf all this, you gotta give him more health. No, I mean, I'm not saying nerf everything, just some stuff. Oh, health pool. I'm not saying give him all of these nerfs. I'm saying there are some things like this shouldn't happen. That shouldn't happen. How far away I am. And he can do it again. Like literally everything he can do, he can loop into itself. So like if I'm on guard, like if I'm just waking up with buttons all day. Oh, I gotta put him back on crouching. This is ridiculous. For real, for real. Whoops. Can't do it. I can't do it on pad. I can't do it on pad at all. I can't. I cannot do that shit on pad. Shit pretty damn cheap. Stamium kick is fine. He can do that, dude. Can't combo super. Nope. That's man. All right. Well, I don't know. I personally think his mid range needs to be nerfed. That's what I'm thinking. Everything I'm thinking of, like with this, because this is all mid range stuff, right? Stuff that like controls the mid range and forces you to deal with shit. This not forcing standing is what I think should be like a big thing. Because if he can keep everything else, I'm fine with him keeping everything else. Making this one hit mid range, it's an anti-air anyway. Fix the hitbox, give it like Cammy's back medium punch like BDN said. And then that would make him normal without totally killing him. You know? Make it so like you can punish this on the ground. I wouldn't say nerf his walk speed. His walk speed's fine. He can be fast. No more fireball on knockdown. No. Actually, no. If you want to keep the knockdown, I say push it further away. No. Oh, he said normal fireball too. He's just all hating. Honestly, though, I think this should go a little further away. Zero. I like that distance. For EX fireball, that distance on normal, I guess slightly further away. Or I'm tripping. It's slightly further away. It's like a couple. It's like a couple point squares over. No. He's still in your face though. No. But he's more in your face here. No. Yeah, it doesn't matter. No. Wait, is he plus four? Yeah, he's plus four. No. Zero. No. No. Yeah. So that'd be me. That'd just be me, right? This doesn't happen. This doesn't force Stan. Give him more fireball recovery. EX air fireball more recovery. Keep this. Cause he can still cancel it, but it'd be cammy back harp back medium punch only with cancelable. And I would keep this. Make it just like Kage's. So that's me. He still has all his tools. It's just when he's in the mid range, he's kinda worse. Because then people can deal with his air fireball, people can deal with stand medium kick. And I think the main thing I'm trying to drive home is that, like, if he could just do this, that's fine versus this. Like, he can do this, he can do that, but he can't do this, which leads into this. That's fine. There's the knockdown, right? He can do, like, he can still do his thing. He can do this. Do this instead, right? He still gets the corner carry. Still gets the plus frames. Now you just... You don't get... What is this? 182. This is still counter hit. So 170, right? You still get the corner carry. You still get the plus frames. You don't get the added damage. Hell, you can still do this. And get V meter. No, I don't want him to have 170 BMBs. Because my thing is this, like, if you give him 170 damage BMBs, the stuff was like, if you catch someone standing, it still works. But this gives Akuma back at the mid range, right? But he can still keep his shit. Wow, that wasn't even a counter hit. Oh my god, this character broke. Wait, that was a meaty, that's why. Yeah, this character is so fucking cheap. He can still get his shit. He can still get this, whatever, right? So do this, knock down, like, he can still get his shit. But I think he's meant to be an aggressive character. He can't, I mean, granted, yeah, he's always been known to do it all, but goddamn. You know what I mean? That's too much. I mean, maybe I don't know what I'm talking about, right? If that's too much, then that's too much, right? I if that's what it is, that's what it is. So I just don't know. If that's the case, then I don't know what needs to be changed for this character. Is either just take away all his shit. I'm not trying to kill him. It can't be just that, bro. It really can't be just that. Like, yeah, I agree with these, but it can't just be those two. Because even then, this is still irritating to deal with. That's still pretty goddamn irritating to deal with. I mean, I don't know. And I really wish I did, honestly. So, I guess with that in mind, I guess I'll call it here. I do appreciate y'all coming in and having this discussion with me, having me try to figure out what it is that is Akuma, right? Like, trying to help me figure out what we can and can't do to keep the character the same without, you know, destroying him. Because I don't want him destroyed. Maybe I was doing things to where I was destroying him. I don't know. But that's why I'm trying to think of it that way. Like, instead of just saying, oh, hey, nerf this bullshit, because that's what we like. This should not happen. No, I'm just trying to think of a fair way to get him to what to get him to where he's like easier to deal with while still being Akuma. So, I don't know. But yeah, with that, y'all, I'm gonna go ahead and call it here. Thanks for sticking around. I'm gonna go ahead and get some rest. I mean, I've been talking about Akuma for 2.5 hours. This was really good. I do appreciate you guys coming through. I really do. BDN, Core Jam, Wolfpack, Town Crier, appreciate y'all. Thanks, Prophet, for the follows and shit. Choncho, JGZ, I do appreciate you guys. Yeah, man, we just gotta. This new outlook on how to, like, find the disease and stop reacting to symptoms. That shit really got me thinking about game balance. It's a really good analogy, right? Because now it's got me looking at it in a different way. So, yeah. But with that, guys, I'll see y'all later. I might stream tomorrow. I don't know for sure. But with that, y'all stay vital. Peace.